Hello and welcome! Grafana Champion is here. My name is Dara Volkova and this channel helps you utilize Grafana to its full potential. Today's video is a plugin review video. I will cover all options for the Base64 Image Plugin version 5.0.0. This video can be a starting point for learning about this plugin or a good refresher. Are you ready for a good time? Let's go! The first release of the Base64 plugin came to life almost 3 years ago. Since then, it has been downloaded more than 1.92 million times. Community members have opened 25 issues, all of which have been solved. We created the Base64 plugin to display images on the Grafana dashboard and then added PDF, videos, and audio file formats. A media file needs to be converted into the Base64 string format and stored in a database, or for small-sized files, you can use the static data source and store the file directly on your dashboard. Let me show you how. I have this file, the Grafana icon. I can convert it into a Base64 string format in multiple ways, such as using one of many free online services, or if my database is PostgreSQL, executing the encode function. After the conversion, the media file looks like this. On the Grafana dashboard, I click the Add menu, then Visualization, and select Base64 from the plugins dropdown. Then on the left, I specify the static data source. I add a field named image with a string type, add row, and paste the Base64 string here. Immediately, I see the image on the panel. Let's look at the available panel options. All the sections on the right are panel options. The first section is Base64 Image Video Audio PDF. This field name is the column of your data frame containing the Base64 string. Field description is the column of your data frame containing a text value that the plugin displays under your image on your dashboard. I add a field name description, and under the value, I specify Grafana logo. Select field description, description. Here on the dashboard under the image, the description appears. The no results message will be displayed if there are problems fetching the media file. I turn off the query on the left, no image, and here is that error message. I enter something different, no image to display. It will look like this on your dashboard. Make the query active again. The following section is toolbar. It works for images and PDFs only. I have an image here, and when this option is enabled, I can specify which buttons on the toolbar I want. My choices are download. This selection enables one button. A user clicks on it to download the image. Navigation. This selection allows for these pagination buttons. To demonstrate better, I will add another row to my data frame and insert another image in the Base64 format, and then add another row and insert an image in the Base64 format. Now look here. The pagination shows 3 as the number of images. I can click the forward button to switch to the second image and then third. By clicking the back button, I go back. I will have the growth image open. The next choice for the image toolbar is zoom. Zoom has 2 sub options. The full screen enables one button to open your image full screen, and pan and pinch enables these 3 buttons. Plus to zoom in and then pinch and move, minus to zoom out. With this button, your image goes back to the original size. For PDF files, your browser usually have its own built-in toolbar. I can disable it or allow it to be shown. For the next example, I use a PDF file with almost 3,000 pages. Let me open it in edit mode. The Base64 retrieves the PDF file from the PostgreSQL database. To learn how to load a file into a database and then display it on your dashboard, please refer to the other video on this channel. Using the describe methods, you can upload images, PDFs, videos, and audio files. Next section, URL, has only 2 parameters. I will enter the Grafana website in the image URL, and in the title, I enter Grafana. Now, when I hover my mouse over the image, I see the text from the title parameter. When I click on the image, the Grafana website opens. In the width and height sections, I can specify the image size. Panel means the image scale will follow the panel size. With original, your image is displayed in its original size. With custom, you can take the size from the data frame field or provide a specific number in pixels. I will set the panel mode for both width and height. In the image section, there is only one drop-down parameter, scale algorithm. It specifies how the image should be scaled. With auto, a browser chooses the best available algorithm. Crisp edges. To better see the difference, I need a lower resolution image. Let me add another image. Use pagination to have it open. Here, now you can see the difference between the auto and crisp edges. The next section applies to video and audio files. I will open another dashboard to demonstrate. This video is retrieved from the PostgreSQL database. I loaded the video file there using the method described in the other video from our channel. In the video audio section, there are three parameters. Controls. When enabled, the panel displays the video and audio controls. Autoplay. When enabled, the video and audio automatically start playing without sound. Infinity play. When enabled, the file plays in an endless loop. These are all Base64 options currently available. Links to detailed documents are available on our website volkoflabs.io under the Open Source Plugins menu. Visit it for more examples and guidance. That is all for now. Thank you for watching and see you next time.